The top names in the 1880s look a lot like a rundown of famous British monarchs throughout history. Ethel and Florence break the top 10 in the 1890s, but for some reason it is hard for me to think of a woman under 70 being named Florence or Ethel. The US is rapidly changing by the 1900s, but not much changes when it comes to parents naming their babies. In the 1910s, the four-decade reign of John and Mary continues. In the 1920s, the Baby Ruth candy bar was wildly popular, but I found out in my research that it was probably named after Babe Ruth and not after President Grover Cleveland's daughter, Ruth. Shout out to my mom, Barbara, who wasn't born in the 1930s, but her name will remain in the top 10 for the next 3 decades. In the 1940s, the name Ronald for some reason stands out to me. Supposedly it had Scottish roots and means mighty counselor or ruler. In the 1950s, companies started advertising pink clothes for girls like Mary and blue clothes for boys like James. This was to make sure siblings couldn't pass down their clothes and parents had to buy twice as much. By the 1960s, the 8-decade reign of Mary comes to an end. All hail Lisa. I couldn't think of anything interesting or witty to say about the baby names of the 1970s, but here they are regardless. Shout out to all my fellow 80s babies. My name didn't make the list, but my parents told me I would have been a Sarah if I was a girl. In the 90s, Girl Taylor makes the list for the first time. What are some other names that can be for both girls and boys? There's a strong Twilight influence in the 2000s, and looks like Team Jacob definitely won. In 2017, the trend continued to give boys first names that sound like last names, and my brother's name finally made the list 30 plus years after he was born. Probably just a bunch of old X-Men fans naming their kids.